Hi everybody, it's Stephanie Mojica, book development coach and book editor. Today I want to talk more about book editing, especially how to choose the right editor for you and your book. And also I want to explain some of the types of editing there are. So the first temptation that a lot of people have come to me have is to choose an editor based on price. Some people, whether it's lack or really serious situations, want to find the cheapest editor possible. Some people think that just because an editor charges like a really high price, I've seen some charge 5 figures, which by the way, I don't charge, that's just my decision. They think that automatically means they're the best editor. Both are not necessarily true. There are great editors who, I've been guilty of this in the past too, charge a little money, and there are awful editors who charge a lot of money. I will say when it comes to editing, in a lot of ways you are going to get what you pay for if you do your homework. So you want to ask an editor, you want to talk to her, him, or them on the phone or on Zoom or a similar platform and find out how many years of experience editing and proofreading do they have. They don't necessarily have to have to edit a lot of books, but you want to find out what's their background. Did they work for a newspaper like I did for 17 years? Even if they were writers, they were also editing other people's work as well as their own. So you want to find out how they learned their editing skills. They don't necessarily need to have gone to school for editing or even writing, but you want to know how did they learn their skills and how are they using them. You also want to find out what kind of editing are they talking about. We have copy editing, which really focuses on grammar, sentence structure, and the like. You have proofreading, where somebody's looking for typos, inconsistent spacing, things like that. You have developmental or content editing, which is a really deep edit where they literally are going to tell you what is missing in your story. Depending on if it's fiction or nonfiction, they're going to tell you areas you need to improve. You need to have a thick skin for that type of editing. So just saying, I do all three, but I mainly do copy editing and proofreading just because I think developmental editing is useful for some people and not useful for others. I think it can be more demoralizing than anything else, but it can also be helpful. It depends on who you are and what your intentions are for your book. So definitely know what kinds of editing you want and don't want before going into a conversation with an editor. And if they don't know these terms and they just keep saying, I'll edit your book or I'll proofread your book, that's a big red flag that they're probably not as experienced as they're saying. Get some testimonials. I, for example, have dozens online. I also have phone numbers, email addresses for my past clients upon request. Talk to some people. Look at their testimonials. When you're looking at testimonials, and I don't want you to think that everybody's out there trying to put one over on you, they're not. But when you're looking at testimonials, see, is it a real person? Editing is not like a confidential coaching therapy thing. So people who give testimonials should be willing to give their first and last name at least, if not also their company name and picture. So just vet the editor carefully and find out what exactly is included in the price they're quoting you. Generally, an editor is going to ask for at least 50% up front. I ask for 50% up front, 50% at the end of the project. If they're asking for the whole thing up front and you don't know them, I would be very careful. Now, I will say as a caveat, some editors, this is how they work. They want the whole thing up front because they've been ripped off too many times. I've been ripped off too with my 50% up front, 50% end, but not too often. You know, I always do a great job. I've never heard anybody say, I'm not going to pay you because I'm not happy with the work. It's more like they ghost you because they ran out of money, especially if they're self-publishing. Also, you want to find out that, you just want to find out exactly what it includes. Get a contract, get things in writing. That's really, really, really important to get things in writing. I use a system called Hello Bonsai that sends contracts and proposals to my clients. Other people use Adobe Sign. Some people just send you the plain old Word document and you sign it and scan it. Whatever works, but just make sure you get everything in writing. Also, find out what's the time frame. How long is it going to take them to do the work? And give them a little grace, although a good editor should always meet the deadline. But sometimes people get into a project, it's a lot more work than they thought. find out if they are literally going to read every book of word of your book word for word, because I will tell you that there are editors out there, especially who are charging little money, that are running it through Grammarly or other software, and they're not reading your work. So you want to make sure that editor is reading every word of your book, preferably multiple times, because software is just not going to find things like the difference between T-O-O, T-O, etc. So just be really careful of that. And also make sure that the editor and you have, you're not going to be in communication a lot during the process, for the most part, that's how I work. But just find out that they really want to make your story look as good as possible rather than rewriting your story to make it more like theirs. I'll tell you, my 17 years in newspaper business, that happened a lot to some of my stories. They were perfectly good stories, but some editors or frustrated writers, or for whatever reason, go on a power trip and start rewriting like every word. You don't want that kind of editor. So I hope that this has been helpful to you. If you're interested in having your book edited and proofread, be sure to reach out to me. I will post a link on Facebook, if you're watching this on Facebook, to my Calendly, so the book complimentary discovery session. If you're watching this on Instagram or Twitter, you can go to my link tree. And on other platforms, I'll also post a link. And just reach out to me. Just, you know, definitely you don't want to skip having your book edited and proofread, especially if you're self-publishing, because I can't tell you how many books there are, reviews are on Amazon, where people are like, this book wasn't edited. So it's an investment. It's well worth it. And I look forward to hearing from some of you. Have an awesome day. Bye.